At present, as we see our country battling the second wave of the coronavirus pandemic, there's a question that pops up in all our brains, and that's quite natural to happen. The question is, what exactly went wrong? If we move back, say, to the month of February, when things were returning back to normal, people almost at that point of time thought that the virus has left us now somehow. And that's exactly when it started to affect us for a second time. By the month of March, hotspots started to re-emerge, and eventually by the month of April, the country was in the middle of the biggest health crisis so far. Now, in a time when we saw the first wave tracing back itself and things normalizing, there are several reasons that one can think of as to why India now finds itself battling the second wave of the coronavirus pandemic. The first reason for this could be businesses getting back to normal. After the first wave, people almost thought that COVID-19 has gone. And from businesses to the government, everyone took a very laid-back approach. They started to become less alert. And this was specifically fed by the move to make the country's economy recover and flourish. Another reason for the same could be the notion of herd immunity that the public was being fed with based on certain scientific opinions. And with this, the restrictions started to become more loose. To add up to all of this, another factor that came in was the slow pace of vaccination. When initially vaccinations had just begun, there was a hesitancy amongst the general public to go get vaccinated. People were also questioning the need for vaccination back in the month of January and February when the cases had started to decline. Along with all of this, there was also a failure to increase the supply lines of the vaccine for the expansion of the vaccination program countrywide. In the second wave, we also saw high number of asymptomatic and mildly symptomatic cases, which was yet another reason that might have contributed to the casual spread of virus in this wave. In the second wave, we also saw a shorter period of incubation of the virus, and this time the virus often directly hit the lower respiratory region and affected younger population too, which is a reason why we saw more emergencies in this wave of the pandemic as compared to the previous one. Also, after the first wave died down, our built-out super capacity of COVID hospitals and railway coaches for that matter went loose. Social engagements, meetings, gatherings started to happen like before COVID. People started to travel across the length and breadth of the country with all their guards being let down, which is yet another reason for the same. Around this time, protests were being organized, religious events were being held along with elections, which further increased the chances of infection of the virus. However, if we take into notice the time when the talk on vaccinations was happening, there was a battle between states and the center, especially between certain states governed by a non-BJP party and the center. And this eventually magnified the poor communication around vaccines at the very local level. Vaccine Maitri, another approach which made India look good when the West was on its knees. And from there began the idea of finding satisfaction in someone else's misfortune or adversity. And overall, if we see, the center opted for a very decentralized approach after the first wave of the coronavirus pandemic. Given the performance of the state, this single act may have contributed to a lot of negative perception of the government of India not doing its job carefully. So all in all, if I had to say, there's no one reason that can be entirely blamed for India's current suffering or misery. But added together, they surely made for something more terrible and more distressing than just their sum.